Don't let your AC system get knocked down by the heat this upcoming summer. Call KS Services and let our team come take a look. We repair and install all makes and models. We even offer a free no-hassle quote and second opinion, so give us a call today. With our flexible financing, you can literally pick your payment. We may even be able to help you knock down that utility bill a bit.
KS Heating and Air, the team ensuring your comfort.
This is your Weather Xtreme video for Saturday, July the 21st. I'm meteorologist Brian Peters. Lots of weather going on across the southeastern U.S. Our surface map features a double-barreled low pressure, one over in the vicinity of Chicago and the other over the outer banks of North Carolina. Fronts drape from both of those to the southwest. In the upper atmosphere, we have a very anomalous pattern for this time of year. This is not what we typically see in July. We do have a strong ridge over the southern Rockies and Texas, but we also have a deep trough over the eastern part of the country that is keeping things a bit cooler. Temperatures this morning, basically in the 70s still, but we do have a lot of thunderstorms around. There's a look at the overall southeastern U.S. radar image, as well as a look a little closer to home. And each of these bookend storms are under severe thunderstorm watches. The watch warning map is rather cluttered here. We do have some severe thunderstorm watches in parts of Alabama and Georgia, as well as Arkansas and Mississippi. And then we have high heat index issues with the orange and the reds that you see. The reds are high temperature warnings, whereas the orange are basically advisories. And those warnings extend over into the southwestern U.S. and up in the part of Dakotas. We have some flash flood watches, as well as over there in Minnesota, some dense fog advisories. Our QPF features a good deal of rain along the east coast of the U.S., somewhat dry there in the central plains. The HPC, or the WPC guys, forecasting excessive rainfall, forecast marginal risk over a good portion of the southeastern U.S. and with those two systems. SPC has a slight risk over a good portion of the state of Alabama for today, and all modes of severe weather appear possible. That risk shifts over into the southeast U.S. coast on day two, Sunday, and then we just have a marginal risk over Florida on day three. And fortunately, the Atlantic Tropical Basin is quiet. Lots of clouds out there over the southwest Atlantic, but nothing that's being watched. All right, let's get to the computer models, the GFS run from 06Z. And there's that anomalous closed low at 500 millibars, producing a good deal of wet weather, stretching all the way from the Great Lakes all the way down across the southeastern U.S., at least for the eastern half of the southeastern U.S. Cape values are very high. They range from 3 to 4,000 joules per kilogram today over much of the southeastern U.S., and I do expect us to see the possibility of damaging straight-line wind, large hail, and possibly tornadoes. The EHI indicating shear. It ranges from values basically anything that's orange or not gray, let's say, is 2 and over. And there's a bullseye of around 9 over the southeast part of the state of Alabama. The closed low and the trough remain in place on Sunday. They move slightly, just a little bit eastward. But that is going to keep us in at least some chance for showers and thunderstorms. At least it won't be as stormy and not likely to be severe on day two there. Monday, the trough is still in place, the closed low beginning to open up, and that just keeps us somewhat unsettled with daily chances for showers and thunderstorms. The trough remains closed again on Tuesday, once again, I'm afraid without the big change in the air mass down low, we still see precipitable water values that stay up, and that keeps us in showers. The trough does open up considerably by Wednesday, so by at least through Wednesday, look for temperatures to be in the 80s for highs. But even on Wednesday, with that trough opening up, we see the possibility of showers and thunderstorms. The trough really is pulled back in terms of its strength on Thursday. But once again, because we're not seeing any real change in precipitable water values staying relatively high, we're going to stay in scattered showers. Friday, the trough is still there, not nearly as strong and as deep as it is the first part of the week. But once again, it's just keeping things somewhat unsettled with pretty good chances for showers and thunderstorms. By next Saturday, the trough still present, and we see the ridge out over the Four Corners area. And that's going to be coming our way eventually, according to the Voodoo Country GFS. But once again, even on Saturday, we're staying somewhat unsettled with shower chances. Speaking of Voodoo Country, the GFS pretty bullish, keeping a trough over the eastern part of the country. That's the 30th of July. We keep that trough fairly strong once again, still a bit anomalous on August the 1st, so no heat visible there. By August the 3rd, the trough is opened up somewhat as we see both a ridge over the Four Corners area and a ridge over Bermuda trying to connect, and the GFS suggesting around the 5th that they might just do that. So it does look like as we get into August, we could see some heat. That'll do it for the Weather Xtreme video for this morning. I'll be back with the next edition first thing on Sunday morning. In the meantime, you can always check back with the blog for notes on Alabama's weather. I'm meteorologist Brian Peters. Have a great day, stay weather aware, and Godspeed.
Summer's just around the corner, and KS Services wants to be the team ensuring your comfort. We repair and install all makes and models, so give us a call today to get a free, no-hassle second opinion.
KS Heating and Air, the team ensuring your comfort.